There are really only two ways you can make money trading, and they are collecting risk premia or exploiting pricing inefficiencies. You really only get rewarded for taking on risk others don't want, risk premia, or by finding mispricings in the market and taking advantage of them if it's cheap to do so. And that's exploiting pricing inefficiencies. You should do both of these things. But you should know that collecting risk premia is uncomfortable, and finding robust market inefficiencies to trade is both uncomfortable and hard. This might be slightly disappointing to you, but it shouldn't be surprising. You wouldn't expect to get paid for something that's easy and comfortable, would you? I like eating ice cream in my hot tub. It's easy, comfortable, and very enjoyable, but I wouldn't expect anyone to pay me for it, and indeed, no one has, at least not today. If it were possible to make money trading in a simple, easy, and comfortable way, which didn't require lots of time, energy, and capital, then soon everyone would be doing it. And it would soon stop being profitable, as prices are driven up by everyone chasing the same opportunities. There are a lot of very smart people out there looking at the same data as you. So if you find something unique that you think has a good risk-reward profile, then you should ask yourself the following question. Why haven't other smart people found this, exploited it, and used up its capacity such that it doesn't work anymore? Now, bad answers you might give to this question might include, because I'm smarter than everyone else, because I worked harder than everyone else, because I have data other people don't have, because I used a fancy machine learning algorithm. Now, whilst it's fun to think of ourselves in heroic terms, these answers are very unlikely to be true. I'm sure you are very smart and very hardworking, but so are a lot of people trading the markets, and many of them work within well-capitalized professional teams. It's also unlikely that you have data others don't have, at least data that you could act on legally. Finally, using a machine learning algorithm, easy for you to say, James, is something anyone with a MacBook can do these days. It's not going to have any edge by itself. So those were bad answers. What might good answers look like? Well, good answers to this question might include, because it has a return profile that's psychologically difficult to endure. It might have negative skew or occasional large drawdowns, for example. Because it requires a lot of operational effort or risk to set up. For example, certain cross-exchange statistical arbitrage trades look like this. Another one, because you couldn't trade it big, meaning it's not cost-effective for the larger, well-capitalized traders to exploit. An example of this would be certain trades in small-cap stocks or micro-caps, and quite a lot of statistical arbitrage trades, shorting leveraged ETFs and things like that. Another one. Because I'm providing liquidity or selling insurance or providing some kind of beneficial service that others will pay for. And finally, and this is probably the most common one, because it's a mirage. What we're observing there is a statistical anomaly that won't hold up in the future. Now, at Robot Wealth, we're not looking for unique things that no one else has found before. We actually want to know that other people are trading things similar to what we trade. And we want to know what's unattractive, what's awkward, and what's difficult about the trades. Because if it's easy, we don't really trust it, because we know we're not the smartest people out there. We know we're not the most well-capitalized out there. So the key lesson in this, you must embrace things that are uncomfortable or awkward. It's one of your best edges that you have as a smaller trader. Now, I hope you weren't expecting an easy ride. This is the greatest game in the world, and the stakes are high, and we can't really expect it to be easy. So to recap, there's two ways to make money trading: collecting risk premia and exploiting market inefficiencies. The first is uncomfortable, the second is hard, and this is a good thing.